name is Jake, and today I'm going to talk about Python Lesson 12, Intro to Functions. What is a function? How to call it? Function groups work together so you can reuse it. You can call a function with name parameters. Example 1, function name is going to be print, and parameter is going to be Jake, so the output is going to be Jake. And it says parameter Jake. Over here, the parameter, that is, and it says Jake. Now, the function name is going to be print, and then the output is going to be, and then the parameter is going to be Amy. And you're printing Amy, so that means the output's going to be Amy. And then over here it says, parameter Jake, so I'm going to say, parameter is going to be Amy for this one. Example 2. Now the function name is going to be range. There's two parameters, 0 and 5, it's 0 list. So it's going to be, the 0 counts as numbers, so it's going to be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 for the output. Now range is still the function name, and then it can be two parameters with different parameters. That is going to be 0 and 3. So, output, that means it's going to be 0 list, so it's going to be 0, 1, 2. Then the 0 counts as a number, then that means in the function it's going to be range. So, output is going to be 0, 1, 2. How to define a function? Function has three parts, name, parameters, and body. Def, test, name. And this is going to be the body, this is going to be the name, this is going to be the parameter. Body, name, parameter, body. So what the body does is make it so print something and make it print be true. My name is a percent s percent name. So percent what a percent s is still it's going to be make the one string. And there's only 1% s. Then one string. Then percent s percent I mean percent name. That means you want to figure out the name. And then it says test. Where was the test? Then look for the test. Whole entire code. And then it sees it in the first one. So, then it says name. Well, what would the name be? Oh, this has to be the name. Oh, that's Jake. So that means we're going to replace the Jake with the percent S. And for us to save, now, that means the output's going to be my name is Jake. Function 1. My name is Jake. Function return a value. Def test value 1 and value 2. Total equal value 1 plus value 2. Then return total. Then calls the function that v. And then I need to press Control Z. I need to go to File. And then I go to. Then go to over here. Second one. Oh, so now I got it back. After that, you press the button, then my mom helped me so I can go back to where it was. Okay, so now it calls a function. So V equal test 2 and 3. What would the 2 be? Oh, that must be value 2. And value 1. What would the 3 be? That must be value 2. And it says plus equal value 1 plus value 2. And then return total. Then that means it's giving it to the V. And then you're printing V. So that means the output is going to be 5. Press to save. Yeah. Bam! And then output is going to be 5. Now, variable scope. The variable defined in a function can be seen in that function. The scope of variable is inside the function. So, same thing except over here, I want to build. Now, I want to press enter. Then print total. No, not total yet. Double quote. Total is space is percent s and then double quote and then percent total and then right parenthesis. So now that I got all that, it's going to return the total. That's the same thing. And then same thing for the rest. And then over here, I'm going to enter 2 times. Then I print, then left parenthesis, total, this parenthesis, and right going to be right parenthesis. And then, now it's going to be because it says it's defined inside the function. So if it's outside the function, you cannot see it because it's defined inside. So that is going to be an error. the number of squares is worth the same, then enter. Oh, name! Name total is not defined because this total is outside the function and it's defined inside the function. The end.